on Inspirational Tissippers. It's Friday, you guys. It's Friday. And I just wanted to come and have like a little inspirational talk. I am sitting outside a possible job. I have to come in here and fill out a paper application. And faith without works is dead, you guys. I have been in a really, really tough season, going through a divorce and moving and all of that stuff, and you know, the whole separation process and all that, y'all. It's been like over a year. Like, I couldn't even, it was hard to walk. It was hard. It's still hard. It's hard to talk about it when I think about how it affected me and the kids. But faith without works is dead, you guys. I am tied into a 2-year lease. So this July will be a full complete year living here. And next year, moving out of this house, renting, I plan on buying my babies a house. And it's really gonna do me some good. If I were to get up and work and add to the income that I already have, things will go, I will be able to make the pot a lot bigger than what I'm able to do now. And plus, I think working right now will be great for my mental. It will get me out the house. It will have me something to do besides the kids all day. I can be an adult. Like, I'm ready to adult. Like, I'm so ready to adult. It makes no sense. But I just wanted to come and talk to you guys about the overwhelming peace that I have. If I go in here and I don't get this job, I have peace about it. If I apply to another job and I don't get that job, I have peace about it. I, at this point, even in my prayers, I'm like, I've done Shantara, Lord. I'm 38 years old. I've been doing me. I don't even know what Shantara wants. You know what I'm saying? I want what you want for me. And that's been my prayers. Like, I don't even know what to ask you because I want what you want. And I know as long as I continue to delight myself in you, you are going to give me the desires of my heart. And I know that nothing that I go through will ever be wasted. So I have peace about this new journey. I've already talked to God and asked him, you know, is working right now something that you want me to do? Because it's not really imperative for me to. But mentally, I think that this would be really, really good. So, but I have peace. It's important to know everything that you do, every situation, every decision that you decide to make, make sure that you have peace about it. And always know that whatever door shuts is not the door for you. The door that's going to open is the door that you are supposed to walk in. Absolutely, for sure. And know that it is of God. And if I don't get this job, to God be the glory anyhow. There's another job waiting for Shantara with my name on it, with the desired wage, with the desired schedule, with, you know. So I'm just going to continue to trust in God, you guys. I am going to continue to have faith in my process, faith in my healing journey, faith in the in me, in motherhood, faith with, you know, if I have to find a child care for my special needs son. I'm just going to walk and believe God. I'm just going to believe God for everything that he has for me. I'm thanking God for our brand new house already, because I know it's coming. I know it's coming. This, I've been in a long season of pain, and I'm just ready for everything that God has for me. And I pray to God that you grasp his peace on today. You grasp, you know, the comfort that the Holy Spirit is always offering, and that you begin to knock on that door so that he can answer you, because he is there. 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 The peace of God is there. The comfort of God is there. And the other day I was asking God, you know, just talk to me, Holy Spirit, just. And then I think I dozed off for like 30 minutes. And when I woke up, all I heard in my spirit was defender. 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 That was the word. I heard the word in my spirit. Oh, I'm spitting it so good. I heard the word in my spirit, defender. Defender. That's all I heard. I heard the word defender. That's what I heard. You guys, God has given me some visions on what I'm supposed to be doing in my life, and I'm just like, I don't even know where to start. I don't even know what to do. I don't even know, you know, but I think I do know you prayer and fasting is what's gonna get it flowing. I ain't never wrote a book before, and I got 2 book titles. I ain't never wrote a book. I'm just like, I don't even know. And it's so scary. You know what I'm saying? It's so scary because you don't know. But I want you to know that fear is going to come. You know, fear is false evidences appearing real. You know, you psyching up your mind for something that might not even happen. But I want you to know that do it afraid. Do it afraid. I'm going to attempt and start, you know, doing what I believe God is calling me to do, to write these books. I don't know where to start, and I don't know, but I'm going to ask the Holy Spirit to lead me. I'm going to ask the Holy Spirit to lead me. I'm going to ask the Holy Spirit to lead me. And so that's what I'm going to do, you guys. I'm on a new journey. I know it's going to be tough with me at home with the kids, and because I'd be so exhausted now. So at working on top of that, but God is going to do it. And God is our defender. You know, he is going to defend us. I don't have to defend, and the Lord told me about my channel, I will give you what to say. So if I tell you to put out a PSA, I'll tell you to put out a PSA. But other than that, you guys, I am not worried about what people have to say about me. I'm not worried about people unsubscribing to my channel. I'm not worried about, you know, who comes and who goes, because to everything there is a season. So I just have so much peace about wherever my life is going. I don't even know, but I know I'm walking in God. I know I'm walking in God. I know I'm walking with him. I know he has anointed me for such a time as this. I know that everything that I went through, it was for a reason and for this very purpose right now, leading me up to where he wants to go. And I know that his will for my life is gonna manifest, and I know that there's a kingdom partner and a kingdom spouse waiting for me, and I know that the life ahead of me is gonna be greater than my former. So I'm just at peace, and I thank God for the Holy Spirit. And I thank God, like, I don't even know what's gonna happen. I don't even know what job I'm gonna get. I don't know, and I really don't care. I don't. Wherever I go, the resources for what I need to do is gonna be there. Wherever I go, you know, information and people that I need to talk to and people that, it's gonna be there. It's gonna be there. He's not leading us for us to be made fools of. He's not leading us to, what you're going through is preparing you for your greater. You have to believe that, though. You can watch these videos all day long, and you can have whatever type of heart and receptive heart, but you gotta believe. You got to believe with everything in your bones that God makes no mistakes and nothing catches him by surprise, and everything that you're going through has a greater purpose. You got to believe that. You have to know that. You have to know that, you guys. You have to know that, and just start thinking about the things that you want to do. Start dreaming about the things that you want to do. Start making baby steps toward the things that you want to do, because the devil is still a liar. God is still good. He has never left us nor forsaken us. He is a rewarder to those who diligently seek him. Yea, though we walk through the valley of the shadows of death, we shall fear no evil, for thou art with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You are my defender. That's not the rest of the scripture, but you are my defender. Don't add to nor take away. You are my defender, Father God. You are here to defend me. You are here to defend me. You are here to defend me. You defend me. You go before me. Holy Spirit, you are the comforter. Holy Spirit, you are our way maker. Holy Spirit, you are our defender. Holy Spirit, you are our burden bearer. Holy Spirit, you walk with us and lead us and guide us. I have so much peace. So much peace. I have so much peace. And I'm excited about the steps that I have to take as far as looking for a job and going through the process and, you know, meeting different people and going where I have to go. I'm okay. I'm excited. And I'm not worried about the no's, because the one yes from God is going to change my life in every aspect. I'm not worried about house hunting. I'm not worried about the no's of the different offers. Because the one yes is going to be the exact house with the amazing neighbors that God wants us to have. And I'm excited about that. I'm excited about my life. I'm excited about my future. I'm excited that I'm answering the call. The Bible tells us that many are called, but few are chosen. Because sometimes life situations and circumstances can knock us down so far that we don't answer the call. And I just thank God that I'm answering the call and that He's choosing a wrench like me. I just thank God that He is taking me out of the miry clay. I just thank God that I no longer feel like I'm in sinking sand. I thank God. So if God is calling you to do something, He's the perfect gentleman. He's not going to bam on your door. He's not going to kick it down and knock it down for you to answer the call. You have to be willing to answer the call. You have to be willing to understand that this life is not yours, and for Him I'll live and for Him I'll die, and those who wish to find their lives shall lose it. And y'all know that scripture that I'm talking about. Those who wish to find their lives shall lose it, and those who lose their life, and those who lose their life shall find it, or something like that. I think it's in Matthew. But yeah, it's in there. But here I am decreasing so that He may increase in me. So the Holy Spirit is a comforter. The Holy Spirit is giving us peace that surpasses all understanding. And I just thank God that I am walking in it. And the days are not perfect. The days are not perfect. But I'm here. Glory to God. I am here. Glory to God, you guys. I did not think that I would make it. Seriously. Leaving the marriage, I thought I was going to literally die. I am here. Like, literally. Standing. God is a keeper. He is the perfect gentleman. He is true to His word. He will do exactly what He said He will do. This is a month of favor. This is a month of grace, you guys. I am claiming it. I am claiming it. I am walking in my victory, and I shall receive a double portion for all that I've been through. And I am going to continue to diligently seek my Father in heaven, so that I can reap the rewards that He has for me. So I just wanted to encourage you guys before I go in here. You guys have a wonderful and blessed Friday. Stay encouraged. Be at peace about what is going on in your life, and know that God is using that to prepare you for what he has in store. So until the next time, inspire, be inspired. I love you guys. God bless you. Good day. So here I am, like an hour and a half later. What time did I get here? 2 hours later. Here I am 2 hours later. Let me turn my ear down. It wasn't even an interview. It was more like an inspirational session. I cried. We praised God. And she said, "Your spirit is what makes me want to say yes to you." That's what she said. She said, "It's your spirit. I can feel your spirit." And she said, "If you are willing to start from the bottom, I will guarantee you that I will get you where you need to go, to where you can be successful in this company and climb the ladder. Allow me to review you every 3 months based on your performance. Allow me to teach you everything I know to get you where you need to be." If my assistant agrees with what I'm saying, if my assistant agrees with me, and you do a second interview right now, and we'll see if she feels what I feel. Have a seat. She'll be with you in a moment. She comes out. I'm being myself. I don't know no other person, no other way to be. I sit, we talk more about my background and what I've done and stuff like that. And she basically said, "I'll help you. We'll help you. I'll promote you. We'll do what we have to do to have you a part of this company. Are you willing?" And based on, because this is the very first job I applied to, I haven't even applied to this job, not even 24 hours. I applied to it last night. Based on the conversation in her background, and she was telling me that she went through a divorce and, you know, but the Lord supernaturally surprised her and restored her whole marriage. So I said, "Father God, I don't know if that's for me, because I'm walking with you. So I don't know, because we ain't no longer dealing with what Shantara want to do and what Shantara think and all that. So I don't know if it was for me to inspire me, but she just encouraged me that everything happens for a reason." It was just confirmation to what I was already saying to y'all before I got in the car. When I was in the car. And we didn't even talk. It was just inspirational. We talked about God and we talked about, you know, how good he is and how everything happens for a reason and how he puts people in your path to help you get to where you need to be. And y'all, I just started crying. And just giving God praise. I was like, I said, "I don't care if I get this job." I said, "No offense to you. I don't care. I don't care if I get this job or not. I don't. I'm walking with God. And whatever he wants for me, I will accept." And based on our conversation, when I first walked in this door and sat down and talked to you, it's confirmation. It's confirmation. So she said, "Give her 3 months and she's going to promote your girl." So I just took a drug test, passed that, and now I have to go and fill out the paper for my background. Supernatural grace. Grace and favor. Grace upon grace and favor, and I give God all the glory. I walked out that building and I couldn't even contain myself. I just started giving God glory. I know where my help comes from. I know what this is all about. And I told her my ultimate goal is to become a nurse. So if I can get all the experience and get all my medication certifications and all my, you know, everything that I need and to be a medication aide and lead the floors and lead these people and all of that, yeah. She said there are people in here who make just as much as nurses. She said, so if anything, this is a company that you would like to stick with. It's clean in there, super clean, pristine, just how I like it. So y'all, they got my praise report. And I don't have nothing on my background. I mean, something happened in 2002, but that was a misdemeanor and that was excused by a judge. So I'm not worried about my background. And to God be the glory. Walk with them, talk with them, allow them to use you, answer the call, because it's popping on this side. I feel foolish for taking this long to seriously walk with God. I repent of that. But he's so gracious and he's so merciful, and it's all been leading up to not only this moment but to what more is to come. So if I'm the example, check me out. Oh, and we ain't gonna talk about this boo-boo vest that I hauled. Y'all, I went to pull it like this and the whole inside ripped. First time actually wearing it. Yeah. Y'all know I gotta keep it real. I gotta keep it real, y'all, but I am like, God is, he's just so faithful. He's the perfect gentleman. He's our father. He's our daddy. Yo daddy, yo natural daddy ain't gonna. Whoo! It's time for Shantara to do what Shantara need to do. And I'm gonna walk this walk with God. And I'm gonna allow him to do what he wanna do. Y'all, cause God wanna show out. He's God. He wants to show out. He like the flex. God like the flex. And I see the flex. I see the flex. He like to show out. He's God. He like to take you through all of this stuff like he did Abraham. Can you imagine Shantara go kill TJ? Oh my God. Going through all of that horror, pain, trauma. Lord, no, why, God, no, I don't want to kill TJ. Go through all of that just to say, they go around in the bush. You ain't got to kill him. Why are you, because I'm God, and I do what I want, and I will, and I just want you to know, to trust me at all times, no matter what it look like, I got you, basically.